coming up here on EA Sports as we come to you from Seattle, Washington for today's game.
Well, Phil, we've got a terrific matchup at running back. Two of the most dangerous backs in the NFL about to meet, go toe-to-toe. How do you see it?
Well, you know what? It's not always about the quarterback when you talk about NFL games. And here's a great example of it today. The game of football is still about the most physical team wins. And when you have running backs like this, the more physical team will win.
First down at the 21. Jackson's going to take the handoff now. Here's a look at the offense. And this core group of wide receivers must find a way to get open today. It's now second down. Wilson's going to take it from the gun. Wilson's got it. First down. He's in the clear. The 20, the 10, taking it all the way home for the touchdown.
Lack of hustle, bad tackling, you name it. They allowed the short throw and catch to go all the way down the field for a score.
The Seahawks with the PAT to come. Add the extra point. The kick is good. The Cowboys take it from the 23 and gains about one. Past winner of the Walter Payton Award, Jason Witten, a steady influence at tight end.
I think you said the word right. It is steady. He just keeps marching along every single year. Big numbers in receptions and putting up big yards too when it comes to receiving yards.
Second down and 9. Williams with the catch. Tackle's made, and that'll move the chains.
When you run the slant route, it's very important to know as a receiver that you're going to catch that football probably in between some linebackers.
At the 34, 66 yards from pay dirt. First down at the 34. Witten's there to catch a ball that had a lot of heat on it. He's taken down at the 23.
Plays are not always going to be perfect. Tight coverage, good throw by the quarterback, and a nice job by the receiver. Catching the football, breaking the tackle, and getting down the field.
field for a few extra yards.
Breaking huddle at the 23-yard line.
Here's the first snap after the big play.
Look at that concentration as he makes the grab.
Romo's able to show off the footwork. Wow, what a good job. Look at those feet. Like a dancer. Gets himself in very good position to throw the football.
Coming up to the line at the 7.
First down here after the completion.
Looking to go up top again on first down. Makes the catch in the end zone. Touchdown.
Clearly, they didn't let the early deficit discourage them. We're all tied up again thanks to that touchdown.
Oh, shoot, of course not. It didn't get to them. You know, this is a game of adversity, and nothing ever goes right, it seems like. But that was a nice drive. Puts them in a spot right now where the game is even, and here we go.
Extra point was good. The Cowboys getting ready to kick it away. And he'll start his return. And he's taken down right at about the 29, not quite to the 30.
The Seahawks offense coming back onto the field after a touchdown drive the last time they had it. They certainly attacked that secondary and got there via the pass.
Well, Jim, let me ask you this. How would you like to be the defensive coordinator right now? Because you're over there, you don't know what's going to happen. No matter what you call, you feel like, hey, the quarterback's hot. He's probably going to beat what we're trying to do.
Jackson is in the backfield. Jackson's lined up directly behind the quarterback here. Jackson's got it on the handle. That hit by Sean Lee. One of the keys to the Cowboys secondary is cornerback Brandon Carr.
Big 2012 free agent signing, and you and I were there when he single-handedly won the game against the Pittsburgh Steelers.
Wilson set, empty backfield. Wilson's going to take the snap from the shotgun.
Wilson with the reception.
Wilson's taken down at the 49.
You got to be agile when you make these kind of catches, running these short drag routes across the field. That time we saw the agility of the receiver. Nice catch.
Playing press coverage to the outside. Jackson is in the backfield. Play clock's running down. Wilson's dropping back to throw once again. The ball is charged loose.
Well, sometimes when you have a talented receiver, you just got to put up with plays like that. He might drop a few, but when he does catch it, it can make a big play.
Wilson's all by himself in the backfield for this snap. Second and 10.
This defense is ready to pounce here early in this game as a third and long play is coming up.
They sure are. There's no doubt about that. They got themselves in a good situation here. If I'm the quarterback now, third and long, I would be very cautious and conservative.
Third and 10. Jeremy Mincy has the sack.
We got to give that defensive front a lot of credit, man. They are pushing. They're getting after it. They know it's probably going to be a pass on third down, and they get back to the quarterback and take him down.
And it'll be Ryan back to punt. They'll take it at the 20. The Cowboys
coming back onto the field on offense. They took it down the field for a touchdown the last time they had it.
Listen, momentum is on their side. When you have that going for you, keep the defense guessing at what you're going to do. So I think it's very important to stay aggressive in this situation.
First down at the 20. To Williams. Two hands on the football and has the catch. The Cowboys have it at the 34. It's intercepted. Late in the first, and it looks like the offense now has a great opportunity to break the tie.
Yeah, now it's time to go out there and get something done. My gosh, you practiced all week. You know, I kept hearing from the coaches, and so did you, Jim, how good they looked in practice on the offensive side. Well, show it to me.
Jackson's taken down.
Nice run that time. When you run the football like this, over a period of time, it's going to wear that defense out. There's no doubt about it. Nice job by the offensive line.
Coming to the line at the 37. The Cowboys lined up in the nickel. The second quarter is underway with this snap. Luke Wilson has the catch. That's a gain of 10. The Seahawks are tied up right now, and part of what's been working for them is the passing game. Wilson's looked in control of the offense to this point.
Hard to believe this game is tied when you watch the offense and the quarterback. They are hot. They're throwing the football. They're making it work. And we'll see if they can get ahead with another drive.
They're able to move the chains after that last run. They better hurry to get the snap. Wilson, and they take him down.
There's a couple ways to get to the quarterback. Run over the tackle or run around him. It doesn't matter as long as you get the sack.
Set up now at the 26. The corners are going to meet the receivers right on the line of scrimmage. Wilson from the shotgun. Throws the pass. And it's batted down.
Well, I know this. When it comes to these situations, don't take a chance, because if you do, I promise you, it's going to backfire.
The Seahawks are going to call a timeout. Want to talk about this third down. The pass play fails to work, and now it's third down. Press coverage all the way.
The defensive line now spreading out. I think they want to try to pressure the quarterback.
Wilson's back in shotgun formation. Intercepted!
Good job that time by the defense. Not being fooled, being in position. When you're in position, you have a chance to make the play. That time they did, they got the interception.
What a difficult spot to be in from here. Pass is intercepted.
Give a lot of credit to the defense this time. They got the offense backed up. It's inside its own 20. They're aggressive. and being aggressive gives them a chance to get the interception, and they make it. Nice play.
Russell Wilson has it under center. Jackson's hand in the football. Coming to the line at the 19-yard line. The Cowboys' defense now is going to go nickel. Wilson's got it in the gun.
Wilson with the reception.
They complete the pass, but still not enough for the first. Third down coming up. Looks like they're in press coverage here. Browns lined up now as the running back behind the quarterback. Locked in on the football and has hold of it with two hands.
Good job that time by the offense. They pick up a first down inside the 20-yard line. Now we'll see if they can punch it in and get 7 points.
First down here. The offense is set at the line for the first down after that completion. Jackson's forcing it across for the touchdown. Midway through the second quarter, they put themselves in front with that touchdown, Phil.
Hey, that touchdown could be a difference maker in this game. You never know, so really well called by the offensive coordinator and executed perfectly by the offensive players.
And the point after is good. Steven Hauschka ready for the kickoff. Gets out past the 20 and brought down at the 24. The Cowboys offense back on the field trying to make up for that costly mistake. The last time they had the ball, the turnover they committed immediately turned into points against them.
Yeah, it did, Jim. But you know what? It's not a perfect game. You got to deal with adversity when you're talking about football. So you made that mistake. Let it go and go out there. Be aggressive and see if you can score some points.
McFadden. He's going to be tackled right around the 24-yard line. We've reached the two-minute warning. Coming up, second down. Whitman's got the catch and the first. That's reception number two for him.
Good job by the offense here. Hustle up, get that football snap, conserve time, and most of all, conserve that timeout. Those are big down the stretch. Not surprised at all to see this hurry up offense in a situation like this. In the NFL now, you got to be the aggressor, and this offense is definitely being the aggressor. Lots of ways to attack cover two. There's no doubt about it. You can throw it underneath. You can pump fake the safeties, make one of them move, and still throw it deep down the field.
That's second down coming up. Very nearly intercepted.
Third long situations. A lot of coordinators in this league will run a draw play on third long. Why? Because they're just looking for field position, pick up a few yards, and then by some miracle, if the running back's able to make guys miss, break some tackles, and pick up a first down, man, that's just great.
From the gun, Romo. Intercepted. That brings the play to an end.
Earl Thomas might be the fastest safety in the NFL, and he uses that speed to his advantage. You think he's back in the middle of the field, you throw the football, and look out. There he is. Nice interception.
Jackson lined up as the single back. Jackson's marked down at the 41. He's averaging about 4 yards a carry. Second down and two to go after the running play. Jackson is in the backfield. Jackson's taken down. The Seahawks call a timeout and are left now with only one. First down here after the run. The Cowboys defense brings in an extra member of the secondary. They'll go nickel. Wilson's on the move. He's got some daylight.
Well, but there's under 2 minutes to go. Good job by the offensive ball carrier that time. He knows he can get no more yards. He steps out of bounds to stop the clock.
Playing press coverage to the outside. Jackson is in the backfield.
Look at the signals. The D line is all shifting down inside. They're expecting a run right up the middle.
Man intercepted. They bring him to the turf.
That was an awesome job by the defense. They just read the quarterback's eyes. They got in position, and they made the interception.
The Cowboys will try to hold on to the football. This has been one big turnover after another, Phil. Just what the coaches talked about in our meetings with him this week about ball security. It's not happening here.
Well, it tells you the players did not listen to the coaches, that's for sure, because ball security is not what we're seeing out there. I know this. Next week in practice, there's going to be a lot of drills about hanging on to the football.
Williams tackled right at the 35. The Cowboys are going to burn the first of their three timeouts right here. They're back at the line after that catch for a first down. McFadden's taking the handoff. That's a gain of 7.
Nothing like a running back who fights for every extra yard or two. What it does, it just creates better situations. Always try to save the timeout or timeouts when you can. It's go to the hurry up offense. Good job.
Cliff Avril brings down the quarterback.
Well, every defense is looking for somebody to sack the quarterback, and that time, the speed of the defensive end gets around the tackle and gets the sack.
Darren McFadden lined up in the backfield. The Cowboys have it at the 34. He's hit as he throws it.
The Cowboys really don't have much of a chance of picking up this first down. It's third and long. Of course, the defense is looking for passes down the field. They're all over everything, and the pass goes incomplete.
And so now they'll bring out Jones to punt. He'll have a chance for a return. They'll mark him at the 22. And a run back of about 8. The Seahawks,
I have to wonder, where are they going to be mentally after that last drive when they were moving the football only to give it away on an interception? How are they going to be out there on this possession?
Well, I think it's tough. I really do, Jim. You know, nowadays, quarterbacks, it seems like all we judge them on, they throw interceptions or not. And once you throw one, it's out there. You've got to get over that mental block, and you've got to keep playing hard and aggressive football. That's the only way you can have success.
Here at CenturyLink Field, Jim Nance and Bill Sims is the third. The second half is officially underway. He's got a chance to return this one. And Morgan's there that time for the tackle. The Cowboys offense trots out onto the field looking to get into the end zone and see if they can turn the tide in this one, partner.
Well, the fact that they are losing this game so far, the sense of urgency is there on the offensive side. You know, you have many plays in that playbook. I think they need to try a few different ones here in the second half.
Now the offense in their hurry up.
Second down and 7.
Complete to Williams. And gains maybe 4. Third down and 2. And he's going to be sacked. So, just 3 plays and out for the offense. The Cowboys have to get to the 49 for a first. The Cowboys have it at the 39. Romo connects with Williams.
The Cowboys did a good job that time picking up the first down. Let's look at the situation. You're behind in the second half. You keep looking to pick up those first downs, and you know you get enough of them. What does it do? Pretty simple. It leads to a score.
Pass is made, but the hit knocks the ball out. Incomplete.
Well, it's so hard to do this nowadays, to jar the football out of the hands of the receiver, but the defender did it that time. He hit him. That football came loose. Incomplete pass.
And a flag is down.
Players from both sides made an appeal, but the referees say it's on the defense.
Look out, they're changing the play to take advantage of something they see on the defensive side.
It's caught by Cole Beasley.
Gains 17. It's first down as they head to the line.
Well, when you play in this cover 3 defense where 3 defenders are playing deep, that's great to stop the deep passes. But who's going to stop the quick ones? Well, nobody. That's why the quarterback and the receivers are having really good success throwing these slant passes.
Comes down with, no, the defender tips it out. The offense heads to the line for the 7th play of the drive. The Cowboys snap it at the 26. That's Romo finding Bryant.
Jim, when you get inside the other team's red zone, inside the 20-yard line, and you're down some points, you're thinking touchdown in these situations.
3rd and 4. Had some heat on it.
The Cowboys, good job that time moving the chains, picking up that first down. And Jim, of course, there's no time to panic in a situation like this. I think they know that. It's in the second half. You've got you're down just a few points. Just keep looking for ways to get another first down, and that'll serve your team well. That's a nice play that time by the defense. The offense is inside your red zone. You've got to stop them from scoring. That was a good job of swatting the football away.
Second and goal from the 8. And the give to Darren McFadden for about 4.
I love situations like this. This is a big play in the game. This really could decide who's going to win or who's going to lose.
Time for the hurry-up offense.
3rd and goal at the 4.
And it's spotted away.
Things get tight down here in the red area. I got to give the defensive man a lot of credit, though. In position, sees the ball thrown, and is able to get that hand up there and knock it down.
Offense still on the field here on 4th down, and they'll need to pick up 4 for the first. A huge 4th down stop by the defense. What kind of momentum boost is that going to give them down the stretch here, partner?
Well, it's not going to hurt anything, that's for sure, Jim. And I'll just say this about their defense. It's been solid all day long. Big stop there, and it's put this team in a great position to really take control of this game.
It's a 2 tight end formation. Here's the give to Fred Jackson. Jackson's met after a gain of three.
Well, that short gain is going to come in handy for the offense. Even if they don't get a first down, those couple yards will make a punting situation a lot easier for them.
The corners are going to meet the receivers right on the line of scrimmage. Second down and seven. Handoff. And it's Rolando McClain who makes the stop.
Running backs in the NFL now, it's hard to bring them down. That time, nice job of breaking the tackle.
Third down following the run. Jackson's going to take the handoff now.
Keep the momentum on your side. You got a lead here in the second half. Nice play that time. You pick up the first down. Let's see if you can take advantage of it.
Jackson is in the backfield. Russell Wilson has it under center. Now first and 10. Going for the home run. Failing to complete that one. So, second down here. Russell Wilson will take it from the gun. And that'll probably go as a drop.
Interesting situation here for the offense. They got a lead here in the second half, but it's third and long. And you always like to say, the football is in the hands of the quarterback, so he has to be smart. If he tries to force it down the field, I do not like his chances.
Third down now.
D-line is shifting inside. They're pinching. I think they're expecting a run up the middle.
Running room. Another third down conversion. The offense continues to come through in the clutch.
The Seahawks, they never back off. That first down, they got a small lead here in the second half. What are they looking to do? They're looking to march this football down the field and score.
First down at the 37. In the end, it picks up only a yard. He's averaging about 4 yards a carry. The offense heads to the line for the seventh play of the drive. The Seahawks take it from the 38. Luke Wilson has the catch. Carr's there to make the stop.
A lot of times you look at the drag route and you think that's the safety valve. You know what? It is. The quarterback is always taught to look down the field. If there's nobody open, throw it to the drag route coming across the field. That time they did it, it's just short of getting the first down.
The Seahawks will come to the line trying to put together a scoring drive here in the fourth. Third down on the way. Double tight end formation. Jackson takes it out of the eye. They're able to move the chains after that last run. The Cowboys with a nickel look here on defense. Wilson from the shotgun. Here's Baldwin. Now they take the football onto the opponent's side of the field.
When you have a lead in the fourth quarter, you like these short completions because you pick up yards and that clock keeps moving.
Wilson's completion percentage, 50% on the day. What a drive this has been.
Second down and 7.
And it's incomplete. Just can't hold on that time.
Got to give the defense a lot of credit there, don't you, Jim? They are all over the receivers, all over the field, nowhere to throw it, and it just results in an incompletion.
Ball spotted at the 49-yard line. The Seahawks need to get to the 42 for the first down. Third down and 7. Wilson's Crawford gets to the quarterback.
Well, the defense has got to be excited. Anytime on third down they make the play, they get pretty fired up. But when you sack a quarterback on third down, that is one happy and emotional defense right now.
John Ryan will be called on to send this one down the field. Fields it cleanly and starts his return. He's going to be tackled right around the 49.
The Cowboys know there's three parts to every football game: offense, defense, and special teams. What a play for the special teams here. Good punt return, good blocking. They get it done.
First down at the 49. Romo connects with Williams.
The Cowboys just picked up a big first down that time, Jim. When you're down in the second half, every first down is crucial. Nice job that time by the offense.
Set up now at the 39-yard line. First and 10. Down the field. It's intercepted. Getting late in the game, and will the offense look to milk the clock or go for the knockout?
Jim, I think they'll go for the knockout. Go out there and try to win the game. Don't look for the other team to lose. You take advantage of this situation and be aggressive.
Jackson is in the backfield. Brought down, but not until he gives his team a new set of downs.
Jackson's a great running back to have on your football team, isn't he? He goes up in there and gets the first down. Now your offense has three more chances.
The clock's really become a factor here, and the defense knows it has to get off the field as soon as possible to give the team a chance. Brought to the ground.
When you get an opportunity like this, you want to take advantage of it. The defense did. The opportunity was there. They get a chance to intercept the football. They do. Now, can their offense take advantage of this situation?
They're happy to begin this drive from this point. This is a time where the quarterback has to manage the clock, has to be very careful. Trailing, needing points to get back into this one. They hurry to the line of scrimmage. Time in this one's running out, and the defense knows it needs another stop.
Good job that time by the defensive player. He reads the quarterback, gets in position, down near his own end zone, knocks that pass down.
It'll be third down. McFadden lines up in the backfield. Here's the handoff to Darren McFadden.
McFadden was looking for a place to run, but there was nowhere to go. The offensive line just gets dominated. Good job by the defensive line that time.
Three-step drop. A nice grab. The ball is fumbled. Recovery by the offense.
The offense knows they caught a big break here. After you fumble and recover it and going in to score, you got to feel good now. Take advantage of that opportunity and go in and punch it in for a score.
First down, pressure on every snap now. Just about 2 minutes to go, and the defense knows it needs to make one last stop to end it. Nothing up the middle here. Wagner on the stop.
What a job by the defense down on the goal line. They were playing run all the way. It was a run. They got the penetration, and they tackled the runner for a loss.
Second and goal from the 5.
To Williams. Touchdown, Dallas Cowboys.
Williams' second touchdown of the game. The Cowboys have erased the deficit and can tie it right here. He made it. The Seahawks are in shape now to return the kick. Just across the 20 and tackled at the 21.
The Seahawks offense back on the field trying to make up for that costly mistake. The last time they had the ball, the turnover they committed immediately turned into points against them.
Yeah, it did, Jim. But you know what? It's not a perfect game. You got to deal with adversity when you're talking about football. So you made that mistake. Let it go. Go out there. Be aggressive and see if you can score some points.
Seahawks coming to the line. Still have all three of their timeouts here in the fourth quarter. From the gun, Russell Wilson ready for the snap. First down at the 34. Has space. And that's the lead in on the stop. Press coverage all the way. We are tied, and this game has less than a minute to go. First and 10. And it's knocked down.
Second down here.
The Cowboys load up the box, going with the 46 defense. Almost intercepted that time.
There's a difference. When you play zone, you drop back and you watch the quarterback and you react to the football. When you're playing man-to-man, all you're worried about is where that receiver goes. You try to shadow him, look for the football, and try to make a play.
Following that incompletion, it sets up third and 10. The Seahawks at the line of scrimmage. Split backfield. It's wide open. Now they take the football onto the opponent's side of the field. The Seahawks are going to burn the first of their three timeouts right here.
Coming to the line at the 40-yard line.
Defense crowd the line of scrimmage. Look out, this could be a blitz.
First down and 10.
Wilson's now going to leave the pocket and tuck it under.
Second down now.
Wilson set. Empty backfield. Wilson from the shotgun. Makes the catch, but didn't get the feet down. Incomplete.
Following that incompletion, it sets up third and 10.
takes it from the gun. There is a flag out. Had it, but dropped it. Well, Phil, he scrambled around, and then he moved past the line of scrimmage when he made that throw.
You know, all you have to do, Jim, as long as some part of your body is at or behind the line of scrimmage when the football leaves your hand, that's legal. That time, easy to see, quarterback way past the line of scrimmage.
Touchback now as the ball comes out to the 20. The Cowboys take the field. The game is tied. And can this offense drive down and win it for them?
Yeah, you got to be alert on the offensive side in situations like this. The defense knows they can't give up yards, they can't give up points. So look for them to take chances and be very aggressive.
First down at the 20. Field, and they can't connect. So here in overtime, the rules change. If you receive the ball first and get a touchdown, the game is over. However, if you take the ball down on your first drive and only manage a field goal, the other team will have a chance to tie or win the game. And if both teams get field goals on their opening drives, the next team to score from there will win the game. The Cowboys are ready to run back this kick. And he's out across the 20 and tackled at the 21. First down at the 21. Here's the handoff. Out of the strong eye. Second and short following the run. Hurry up. 2 minute offense. Darren McFadden will run with it. Tackle's made and the first down is picked up.
McFadden's a very smart runner. He knows situations in the game. He saw the first down yard markers, and what does he do? He gets past them and picks up the first down.
The Cowboys from the 32. Another handball. And they are in on McFadden. No time to waste. They hurry to the line. The Cowboys take it from the 38. They call his number once more. Third down. The Cowboys need to get to the 42 for the first down. What a hit, and the ball falls incomplete.
Williams has really hit hard that time. And I know the football hit his hands, but when a defender times it perfectly like that, with that much power and speed going into that receiver, you are going to let that football go. That's human nature. Really good job by the defensive player.
The offense still on the field here on fourth down, needing four to stay on the field. The Cowboys take it from the 38. Gavin Escobar has the catch. The football rests at the 44. First down at the 44. Takes it from the strong eye.
Turpin's a dangerous runner when you give him room to run, but there is no room this time. What a job by the defense. They bottle him up for a short gain.
Second and six. The Cowboys get a first down.
Hey, let's team. Let's go.
coming to the line at the 27.
First down here after the completion.
McFadden. And that's Rubin in on the spot.
Wasting little time.
To Williams. That's Wagner making the stop.
This long drive continues. Third and three.
Tony Romo's pass was intended for Jason Witten.
The Cowboys go with the pass that time on third short. The defense was ready, and they stopped the pass. Now we have a fourth down situation.
Danielle's got an injury update for us. Let's go to her now.
Guys, I had a chance to speak with a Seahawks team official. As of now, the staff is calling it a groin pull. In addition, it's hard to pinpoint when he could return from this injury, but this will most likely keep him out of the lineup for a couple weeks, guys.
Jim, they get the field goal there that time, and it keeps the momentum on their side. It's positive energy. It makes you feel good. Now we'll see if the defense can carry it on.
The Seahawks are set to return the kickoff. Just past the 20. We'll mark it at the 22-yard line. Jackson is in the backfield. First down at the 22. Going for the deep ball. Incomplete.
Well, my man at quarterback does have a strong arm. He showed it that time, didn't he? He threw that thing high and far and just overthrew the receiver.
After the incomplete pass, it brings up second down.
Wilson's got no one behind him. Just a quarterback waiting for the snap. Halfway into the overtime period. Wilson's got it and a first.
First down coming up.
Looks like they're in press coverage here. Wasting no time now for this next play.
Wilson standing back in the shotgun ready for the snap. That's a gain of six. That's his eighth catch of the day.
I don't know what the answer is when it comes to guarding these tight ends now. There's just not much you can do. I'll tell you the best way to stop the tight end, rush the quarterback.
Oh, it almost picked off that time.
Well, the quarterback can't get him open. He threw to the right guy that time, but the coverage was so good by the defense, nowhere to get the completion.
It's third down coming up.
Wilson's going to take it from the gun. Wilson's got it on a pass that had some heat. First down here.
No need to huddle. Hurry up offense.
Wilson's going to take the snap from the shotgun. Is it caught? Yes! The offense has the ball!
Just 2 minutes left in this one now. Back in a moment.
It was basically a jump ball there, Phil. And both players had an equal shot at it, but it goes to the offense. How did he do that?
Yeah, we see it more and more in the league, don't we? The quarterbacks are taught. If they're both there together, go ahead and give your wide receiver a chance to make the catch. It was tight, it was close, but it went to the wide receiver.
Now they'll try over again on second down.
Jackson's got it on the handle.
Jackson's met after a gain of three.
Well, that last play almost got him in here. And when you look at this, what do they do? Well, you just want to punch it in. There's a lot of different scenarios. You could do a play-action fake, probably get somebody wide open, or have a running back.
It's a walk-off touchdown beyond belief.
Oh, you just love it as a quarterback. You get down in there, and it's first to go. If you score, now you don't have to sweat the fact that, man, what are we going to do if it gets to third down? You don't have to worry about it. Good run. Nice touchdown.
So for Phil Simms and all the crew at EA Sports, Jim Nantz saying so long for now.
It's the NFL on NFC East teams about to go at it as we join you from MetLife Stadium.
Bill, we've got a couple of the best tight ends in the game on each sideline today, and they could be the difference makers.
You know, these tight ends, they can do it all. They're tremendous blockers for the running game. They got the speed to go down the field, and they got feet, Jim. You know, those quick feet, so even when they run those short routes, if there's man-to-man coverage, they're quick enough and shifty enough to still get away from the defender.
the Giants will take the snap from the 30. Got the first, and he's got some space.
First down here after the run.
Playing press coverage to the outside. The offense stops the clock right away with a timeout.
Coming to the line at the 45. First down at the 45. Jennings. That's a gain of six.
And that's the type of run I think this offense would take all game long, Phil.
Oh, would they ever? They would love this. This is showing your dominance here. The offensive line doing a good job, but also solid job by the running back picking up some good yards. Good job by the defense. All shifting inside. They're expecting a run up the middle.
And that's a gain of nine.
Jim, let's keep our eye on the defense. If they keep giving up runs like this, they're going to have to change what they're doing on the defensive side. Maybe bring another guy down in the box to stop those runs. Quarterback sees something in his defense he wants to take advantage of.
First down at the 30. And they deck the quarterback.
Well, if I was that quarterback, I'd be mad. After getting sacked like that by the defensive end, your offensive tackle's just got to do a better job.
The Giants snap it at the 36.
It was right there, but he didn't bring it in.
Let's set the lineups now for this offense. The former Giant at wideout and former first-round pick, Hakeem Nicks.
When he is healthy, he is a solid NFL wide receiver. He's got to stay healthy. He's got the speed and the size. And he's got some of the biggest hands in the NFL.
The Cowboys' defense now is going to go nickel. The Giants snap it at the 36. He's drilled as he throws.
The Giants put themselves in a situation where the defense has all the advantage. They know the pass probably has to go down the field.
Set to punt here. The play clock's running down. This punt will not be returned. It will never see the field of play as it sails out of bounds. First down at the 21. McFadden's hand at the football. Gets about 9 on the play.
When you run the football like this and you show toughness, there is no doubt when you fake it and try to throw the football down the field, the quarterback's going to have all day to get it done.
Second and short following the run. Tony Romo will take it right from the center. Give to Darren McFadden. The tackle's made and the first down is picked up.
McFadden's a great running back to have on your football team, isn't he? He goes up in there and gets the first down. Now your offense has three more chances.
Now first and 10. Looking across the middle. Williams had it, but couldn't hold on as this goes incomplete. As we check now, this offensive unit getting it done for over a decade. Certainly a future Hall of Famer is tight end Jason Witten.
Well, we hear it all the time from the Cowboys offensive staff. They say everybody underestimates how fast he is, how physical he is, and if the defense gets the sack. Outside linebackers in the NFL, they are such tremendous athletes. They can do everything. How about that play that time? Good move, good speed, gets to the quarterback and gets a sack.
Loss of four on the play. And a flag comes out. Look at that concentration as he makes the grab. They'll decline the penalty and let the play stand.
Jim, they call that a post route. Do you know why? The receiver is running towards the goal post, so they call it a post route.
First and 10. And incomplete as Witten can't hold on. Take a look at the defense now. John Beeson, a player we should be calling many times today.
Yeah, he's a smart player. There's no doubt about that. And he can diagnose the runs and get in there and make those tackles. And, of course, the other thing he does, he knows how to cover the tight end and get in the right spot to alter the throw to the quarterback.
Second down and 10. To Williams. And the catch by Terrence Williams.
Tony Romo does everything well. He moves around. He can throw it deep down the field, and he is very good at this also. Play action passes. Good fake by Tony Romo. Good throw.
They come to the line at the 31-yard line. Let's see how they back up the big play here. The give. Ayers. That time on the tackle. Second down coming up.
They're changing things here. The quarterback changing. He's giving the receiver some new instructions.
Williams with the catch. And that's a gain of 9.
Good job that time by the quarterback. Looks down the field. Nobody open, so he throws the drag route. Coming across the field, and it's a nice catch. Just short of the first down.
Third down and 1. And it's batted down.
Good job that time by the defense on third down. Find a way to get off the field. The defender found the way. Knocked that pass down.
Bailey set now to attempt the field goal. The kick is through for 3. We're late in the first, and that field goal puts them on top.
Yes, and it's a confidence boost, no question about it. When you get a field goal or a touchdown late in the first quarter and it puts you on top, it just feels good.
The Cowboys ready here for the kickoff. He'll have a chance to take off. Gets away. Keeps his legs moving. He steps out. That return's good for about 31. The Giants heading back out there on offense, hoping to improve on their last possession, which ended rather quickly with a punt.
Yeah, I think what they got to do, they got to come out and be a little more creative. Get the defense off guard. Make them think over there. That was too generic what they did on the offensive side. If you want to score, show some ingenuity.
The Cowboys defense brings in an extra member of the secondary. They'll go nickel.
Now he's going to change the play. Look out. I think he's going to go down the field with the football.
It's into the surefire hands of Odell Beckham Jr. First and 10. And Jennings going to secure the handoff.
Good job by the defense. They stopped the offense that time on first down. Now the defense is in a good situation.
Second and 11. Oh, this kid can put up the highlights. Beckham again with the catch.
Look at the defensive line. Everybody shifting to their left.
We're now about to begin quarter number two. And how much pressure do you think these offenses are feeling right now to open this game up, partner?
Jim, I'm going to go back to when I played. The longer you go in a game without having success, I think it makes you tighter and you lose confidence on the offensive side. So they need something here to get them off to a quick start and get them feeling good.
And the second quarter is underway with this snap.
Jenny is a very smart runner. He knows situations in the game. He saw the first down yard markers, and what does he do? He gets past them and picks up the first down.
He'll throw it over the middle. Jennings is brought down in the red zone.
The Giants did a good job there on first down. That pass picks up some good solid yards. Now second and short. Much easier to call those kind of plays.
It's second down and three. He rips it right out of the wide receiver's hands.
Sometimes when you have a player with this kind of talent, you're willing to put up with a few drop passes because when he catches it, he has a chance of going all the way.
The line of scrimmage is the 16. And three. Jennings taking the handoff. He's tackled beyond the markers. It's a first down.
Good job by the offense getting the first down in the red zone. Now it becomes tricky. Can you deceive the defense where you get a chance to get a score?
Doesn't like what he sees on the defensive side, so he is changing.
Pass is intercepted. We got a tight one early in the second quarter, and now the offense will look to build on the lead coming off the interception.
Yeah, you know, it was a good job by the defense taking nothing away from them, but what was the offense thinking with that play call and that throw by the quarterback?
Backs to the wall for the offense.
Nice job that time of the outside linebacker getting the sack. They ask a lot of these guys now. They are special players in the NFL. Stopping the run and the speed to get outside and get the sacks on the quarterback, too.
Loss of four on the play. Second down and a long way to go. Complete to Williams. Williams is met after a gain of three.
Well, if you're the offensive coordinator here in a third long situation and you're winning a close game, you'd like to pick this up. But also, you got to make sure you call a play that doesn't put the offense at too much risk. Tough call coming up here for the coordinator.
McFadden, solo back set. Third down and 12. Takes the hit, throws.
Let's give the defense a lot of credit. They got the offense in a third long situation, and the pass goes incomplete. The offense, well, you just got to do a better job not putting yourself in those situations.
And so now they'll bring out Jones to punt. Harris going to look for space now. Turns good for about 14. The Giants have to still be thinking about that last possession. They were actually moving down the field. And then, of course, the untimely interception ended things.
Yeah, the defense, look, they got good players. And, you know, you give them enough chances, they're finally going to make the play. You have to be careful with the football. The offense was not, and that's why it resulted in an interception.
What do you think they're talking about in that huddle after that drive-killing interception?
They're probably telling the quarterback, if you do that again, we're going to kick you out. I don't know, but they got to play better.
First down at the 44. Intercepted. And not only does their defense protect the lead, they force the interception and give their offense a chance to increase the advantage before halftime.
Good job by the defense. You know what they did? They just put more self-doubt into the opponent's offense. They're going to have a hard time snapping out of this today.
First down and 10. Here's the handoff to Darren McFadden. Tony Romo will take it right from the center. Second and long. Almost intercepted.
You got to be smart on the defensive side now here, third long. Be a little careful. Maybe give up a short pass or a short run. And if they throw it short, make sure you come up and make the tackle.
The offense now needs to pick up the first here on third down after that incompletion. The Cowboys line up, split backfield. Midway second quarter. Tony Romo uncorks the long pass.
The Cowboys don't have a lot of options on third and long situations. The pass goes incomplete, and the defense did a good job of staying back there and not giving up the deep throw.
They're set to punt it away now. Harris has got it on the return. Tackled down at the 47.
The Giants love this type of play. Of course, everybody would. If you get a good punt return, that's what you want. And, of course, it helps when you have an explosive punt returner back there.
First down at the 47. Jennings going to take the handoff now. It's now second down and 7 after the 3-yard rush. Manning from the shotgun. At it for a moment, but the ball is knocked out incomplete.
Well, the defense has got to love that. They love it when a quarterback is uneasy for whatever reason or just not in rhythm. That time they see him throw off the back foot and the throw goes incomplete.
Now looking at third down. The Giants need to get to the 43 to pick up a first. Handoff by Manning. He's brought down. That's going to bring up fourth down. It's becoming evident here, partner, that this defense has done quite a job so far and is ready for this occasion. I know it's only the second quarter, but they've dictated the pace of this one.
You are right. I know it's early in the game, like you said, but so far the defense is winning the battle, and I think we kind of expected that coming into today's game.
The Cowboys might have been caught off guard there on that fourth down play.
Well, why? Why would you be caught off guard in a situation like this? You always have to be ready on the defensive side. That time they were not.
Halftime, 2 minutes away. The Cowboys lined up in the nickel. And Jennings got on the handoff. He'll pick up 7 this time.
You know, you go to the hurry-up offense so you can get a high number of plays in, but also you don't want to use the timeout. When you're trying to score some points at the end of the first half, the best way to do it when the time is against you, get in that hurry-up offense. Make the defense sit back. Be real careful about what they're doing. Maybe you can get some quick yards and get a chance for some points before halftime rolls around.
First and goal from the 7. Jennings handed the football. Over the line. Touchdown. A big touchdown right there. They're almost sure to take the lead to the locker room with that score.
All touchdowns are big, man. They're all exciting. They all make you feel great. And right now, the offense, they are feeling great about what they did on that last drive.
And the extra point is good. Josh Brown about to boot it down the field. They're setting up the return. And he runs it out to about the 27 before he's taken down.
The Cowboys weren't able to get anything out of their last drive and were forced to punt. As they take the field here, do you think they are going to vary their approach, Phil?
Well, I hope so. I think they will. They got a lot of information out there in that short drive, Jim, and you do that by showing different formations and plays. You saw how the defense reacted to it. Now you counter-react and see if you can get some positive plays.
I'm sure they're tired of being in the three-and-out business.
Well, it's a bad business to be in. I know. I get in a lot of bad businesses. Good job by the offense going the hurry-up offense. You do this to get the plays in, but also you want to conserve the timeouts.
Williams tackled down at the 43.
I like this decision by the coach to go with the hurry-up offense here late in the first half. You can't be worried about making mistakes. Sometimes you got to be aggressive.
The Giants decide to take a timeout here, leaving them with only one. Tony Romo will take it right from the center. The catch is made by Witten.
Romo selling this play big time. The defense, they go for the run fake, and that's why he has time to throw the football and makes the completion. Good job. Managing that clock, such a big deal in the NFL. That's why they're hurrying up. Don't use that timeout. Keep those timeouts because that is going to maybe give you a chance to win the game. Jim, a good decision here by the coaches to go into hurry-up offense right before halftime. You want to get as many plays off as you can before the halftime whistle blows.
This is third down. To Williams. And it's swatted away.
Gets tight down here in the red zone. So if you're a defender, read the quarterback. You make a quick break on the football. Hey, you get in position like this, you can knock it down.
Lining up for the field goal. He's 1 for 1 so far today. And the kick is good for 3.
And that should put them a little more at ease come halftime.
Yeah, I think it will. I think it gave them a confidence boost. And they gained confidence. On the other side, I think they lost confidence because of that field goal.
The Giants prepare to return the kickoff.
tackle's made. And a run back of about 19.
The Giants offense preparing to get this drive underway. Their last drive actually ended in a touchdown, Phil. We'll see if they still have it in them to issue a repeat performance.
Well, what you saw in that last drive was everything just came together perfectly for them. The experience of the football team, the talent of the players, and the coaches helped them out. They got it done.
The Cowboys sat at the line. Dime package. First down at the 17. Manning's looking to go down the field here. Almost intercepted.
One half down and both offenses still searching for answers. We've got a defensive battle on our hands, and Larry Ridley is coming up next.
Brown will be kicking off momentarily as we get the second half underway.
With this kick, the second half is underway.
Takes off from the 5. And he's taken down right at about the 29, not quite to the 30.
The Cowboys talked things over at the intermission, and I'm sure one of the first orders of business was to try to figure out a way to get this offense going, Phil.
Absolutely. That's what you want to do, and I think you do that by play call. So the coach, they have many plays that we call drive starters. Catch the defense by surprise. They need to call one of those right here and right now to get this offense going.
Let's go.
The Cowboys have it at the 29. And they are in on McFadden. He's averaged about 2 yards a carry on the day. And now they're in the hurry up. The Cowboys take it from the 33. Romo's unable to find his target that time. On the way, third down. Defense does his job, forcing fourth down in a hurry. The Cowboys not punting, going to go for it on fourth down.
The quarterback's picked up on something. He's changing the play here.
The Cowboys take it from the 33. The Cowboys turn the ball over on downs. How about that defense responding to the fourth down challenge to get things started in the second half here, Phil?
Well, they probably couldn't even believe the offense was going for it on fourth down. When you're in a low-scoring game, what does that tell you? Offenses are not doing that well, but they take that chance, and it backfired.
First down at the 33. Lawrence is in on the tackle. Second and short following the run.
Always good to have these types of runs. Hey, it's not a first down, but it sends a message. It shows everybody that you can run it when you want to. And also
throws it in the end zone. Touchdown.
Nice throw by the quarterback that time. Put it right on the money. Not a big window. It doesn't matter to him today. Great control of the football. Put it right in there for the touchdown.
The Cowboys are ready to run back this kick. Steps up and fields it at the 2. And the tackle's made right around the 25-yard line.
The Cowboys ready to take over again. They rolled the dice on their last possession, Phil, going for it on fourth down in their own territory. And, of course, they failed to convert.
Look, there's nothing like being aggressive. I like being aggressive, too, when I'm the coach of the team. But, listen, that was just uncalled for. When you're in your own territory, be smart, punt the football, and wait for the next opportunity.
On his way, the 30. Witten's taken down at the 25.
The Cowboys look pretty confident out there on the field, don't they? And they're very calm, and they should be. That first down, they're right in this game. Don't look down the field for that big play. Just keep marching.
Romo's completion percentage, 50% on the day. Two hands on the football and has the catch.
When you get down in the red zone, the offensive coordinator's got to call a play that deceives the defense. Let's see if he can do it. His team is down. He needs a big play here.
The Cowboys. Touchdown. And this game just got a whole lot more interesting.
Tight ends are a position where you got to be able to do it all. You got to be able to block, run routes, and you got to be able to get in position so you have a chance to catch the touchdown pass. Good job by the tight end. Touchdown.
Momentum that turns into an 8-point trip, the touchdown and the two.
This offense and the head coach and the offensive coordinator, they're all aggressive. So hey, well, it's not good enough just to get a touchdown. They want to get that extra point or 2 points. Nice job that time.
Harris elects to run it out. They stop him from running it out to the 20. Mark him down at the 19. First down at the 19. Rashad Jennings with the reception.
What's the old expression? Just move the chains. That's what they did with that throw and catch that time, Jim. It also gives them a chance for three more downs.
The offense is set at the line for the first down after that completion. Jennings tackled down after a gain of two. They get set quickly, ready for another snap. The sack of the quarterback by Greg Hardy.
Man, this defensive end, Jim, he is some talent. That time, good job, makes the move, shows the speed, and gets around there and gets the sack. Look at the defensive line shifting all down to the inside. They're pinching. They're expecting a run right up the middle.
And this goes incomplete as he was looking over the middle. Pretty outstanding work by the defensive coordinators in this one today, Phil. Third quarter, and it's all about the D.
Yeah, give the defensive coordinators a lot of credit. They came into this game with awesome game plans, and the players right on top of everything, and they've played well.
They're in punting formation. He's going to challenge the punt coverage. Taken down at the 39. And a run back of about 8.
The Cowboys offense taking the field again. They got everything they could out of that last possession, Phil. That was a solid touchdown drive.
Yeah, just look at them, Jim. The way they run onto the field, you can see they're exuding confidence. And when you got a confident football team, man, let them go and let them play and see if they can make it happen again.
Let's go.
The Cowboys have it at the 39. McFadden's tackled down after a gain of 7. They're going to the hurry. Back to the line now. Second down, 3 to go. To Williams. Williams tackled down at the 38.
Over.
They're back at the line after that catch for a first down. Tony Romo hits Jason Witten with that pass. The offense coming to the line inside the opponent's 20.
When we were at practice on Friday, Jim, this team was working on red zone offense all the time. Well, here they are. It's a tie game. We'll see if all that practice pays off.
With the contact, the ball comes out.
Well, the quarterback that time tried to squeeze it into tight coverage, but no can do. The coverage is too good, and the football falls incomplete.
Second and 10. And he's thrown to the ground.
Outside linebackers who can get to the quarterback, they are a rare breed in the NFL because it takes talent, size, speed, everything to do it as a linebacker. And we saw it that time on display.
Got drilled as he throws it.
Well, that's not the worst thing that can happen to you in a situation like this. As long as the football is not intercepted, that's okay.
Bailey's lining up for the field goal. He's 2 of 2 so far today. And he converts here on the field goal try.
Another nice kick by the kicker. Man, oh man, is he hot. He has got such confidence, got a powerful leg, and it is all in rhythm today.
The Cowboys now getting ready to kick it away. Harris is going to test the coverage here. Just across the 20 and tackled at the 21. The Giants bringing their offense onto the field. It wasn't a very productive possession for them last time out, partner. They ended up punting.
Well, you know what it was? It was a good feeling out process. So they got some knowledge by watching the defense and what defenses they tried on them. So you got to take advantage of that knowledge and come out here and make some plays.
First down at the 21. Gets the handle here. And Jennings is brought down. No huddle time.
Quarterback likes what he sees out there outside. He's changing the play with the wide receiver.
Second down and 10. Heaving it down the field. Nice catch. Gonna take it home for the touchdown. We're heading to the fourth, and partner, they look to have seized command of this game with that touchdown.
Oh, I think they have. They have seized command, Jim. They put the pressure on the other coaching staff and the players. This is a great spot to be in.
Josh Brown about to boot it down the field. Charging ahead. The Cowboys back on the field with their offense now. They've scored on each of their last two drives and have to be feeling pretty confident right now at the start of this one.
Yeah, it is amazing what the mind can do sometimes on the football field. You go out there and you score and you feel like nothing can stop you. So would not be surprised to see them to go out there and have success again.
First down at the 28. Incomplete. Almost going in the other direction.
That was excellent man-to-man coverage at time. When you want to shut down a receiver, really the only way to do it is to man up and play him one-on-one.
The lineman tries to plead his case, but it looks like a false start. And now, after the penalty, it's second down and 15. Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Second and long. And he's forced to the ground.
This defense is awesome in blitzing. That time they blitz, they get the sack on the quarterback. They time the snap count perfectly and catch the offense by surprise.
No time to huddle now.
taking off. And it falls incomplete.
On the offensive side, when it's third long, all you want to prevent is the turnover. You did that, so it's a victory for the offense.
They bring back out the offense to go for it. And he knocks the ball out of his hands.
Well, let's try to get into the mind of the coach here. Maybe he doesn't trust his defense. That's why in a close game on fourth and long, he went for it. It did work, so we'll see if his defense can bail him out.
The Cowboys will use a timeout here early in the second half. Hey, the offense has a chance to do something with this drive. First down at the 15. And Jennings going to secure the handoff. That's a gain of 8. He's up over 90 yards so far on the day. They'll go no huddle. Eli Manning takes it from the gun. Jennings with the catch. Jennings marked down after a gain of 4. They're just grinding away down here, inching closer to the end zone.
Well, that's what you got to do sometimes. It's hard always to think that you're going to come out and just make big plays. You've got to do the dirty work, and this offense is doing it right now.
The Giants have the football as the fourth quarter gets started. The ball is just 3 yards out of the end zone. The corners are going to meet the receivers right on the line of scrimmage. He'll take the snap, the first here in the fourth quarter. And this will end up as a 2-yard loss.
When you get third goal, a lot of times it just comes down to who's willing to fight the hardest. We'll find out here in a second. Quarterback, he's changing the play with the wide receiver with those hand signals.
Can't find the target on the pass underneath. Needing 5 to move the chains. Press coverage all the way. They go screen with Jennings.
nowhere to go, as this will be a loss of three.
Anytime you go forward on fourth down in the NFL, that's a big play. And when the game is close in the second half, it becomes a huge play. That was a wonderful job by the defense stopping them there on fourth down.
They're going to get him here for a sack.
You know, outside linebackers, they're everything all in one. They got to be a pass rusher, a pass cover guy, and they got to be able to stop the run. Nice job that time getting the sack.
And it's knocked down.
Well, the most common thing that most offensive coordinators do in the NFL on third long situations, they're going to call a play where they probably don't think they're going to pick up the first down, but they're looking for field position.
Third down and trying to get out of here with their lives. Tony Romo is going to take it from the shotgun. The pass falls incomplete, and they fail to pick up a first down on this series. And so now they'll bring out Jones to punt. Harris got a chance this time. And he's going to be tackled right around the 37.
Harris is such a great athlete. You've got to find ways to get the football to him. Here's another way to get it to him. On a punt return, how explosive is he? Man, Barry, that's the answer.
Great starting field position for the offense. Looks like they're in press coverage here. The Giants from the 37. Jennings taking the handoff. He's averaging 5 yards per carry on the day.
When you lead the game in the fourth quarter and you're on offense, you are looking to use the time up on the clock. So that was a nice play call by the offense to run. Defense stops it for a short gain.
And it's Lee who surges in to make the tackle quickly to the line.
Look out, they're changing the play to take advantage of something they see on the defensive side.
Rashad Jennings with the reception. Well, they convert this time, but they've had a tough time all day long on third down. First down here after the completion. They'll run it here. And Jennings is brought down. That's going to be a pickup of three.
Good job that time by the defense. They're down. It's in the fourth quarter. They are expecting the offense to run the football, and they stop it for a couple yards.
Getting set as fast as they can. He makes the catch.
Nice job that time by the offense getting the first down inside the red zone. And it's a good thing they got a quarterback with a strong arm, because you've got to throw into some tight spots in the red zone.
Inches to go. They need to get the playoff. They'll go ground. Mincy's able to read that play and make the hit. They're going to the hurry up offense, and they're back to the line quickly.
Good job by the defensive line shifting all down inside. I think they're expecting a run up the middle.
The offense heads to the line for the seventh play of the drive. Third and goal from the three. And intercepted.
You got to stay aggressive on the defensive side. That time the defense did. Even though the offense was going in to score, they finally come up with the big play, and they get the interception inside their own 20-yard line.
The Cowboys in quite a battle here in the fourth. The scores
21-17.
First down at the 20.
Strong eye handoff here. Second down here after that run play. They're going to the hurry.
This game is not over, but the quarterback knows that time is short, and his team must do something in a hurry.
The Cowboys did a good job that time picking up the first down. Let's look at the situation. You're behind the second half. You keep looking to pick up those first downs, and, you know, you get enough of them. What does it do? Pretty simple. It leads to a score.
Knocked down as he fires it. Second down following that incompletion.
We're drawing near a close, and the defense is trying to preserve a victory.
Dez Bryant with the catch. Just 2 minutes left in this one now. Back in a moment. Coming up, third down, a huge moment. Third down and 4. Got hit on the release.
There's a fine line there when you're winning the football game. What do you do on the defensive side? Well, that time, the defensive coordinator stayed aggressive, and he forces a fourth down by the offense.
The coach is going to go for it. They'll go for it on fourth down, late stages. Cowboys turned the ball over on downs. Romo's unable to come through on fourth down. And with that failed possession, they may wind up walking out of here today wondering what could have been.
They're going to be so disappointed because all year long in these type of situations, they have been very good. But that was just, it was not meant to be, and they couldn't come through on fourth down.
I am shocked they were unable to convert.
Quarterback sees something in his defense he wants to take advantage of.
First down at the 38. One-handed catch.
The Giants offense, they know it's more than just about their defense. The offense did a good job that time picking up the first down. That's what you want to do. You got a small lead in the second half. Keep getting those first downs and eat that clock up. Jim, the offensive coordinator, has done a terrific job so far here today. He's got his team winning. They're in the red zone. Let's see how clever he's going to be on this call.
First and goal from the 9. Gets it out for the completion. Carr's the one who brings him to the ground. How will they handle this, Bill? Late stages and just trying to avoid a turnover, but a touchdown could put this game away.
I think what they'll do, Jim, they'll have a little gimmick play here because the defense is going to be too aggressive, so you take advantage of that and call up a play that they're not expecting. I think that's what the offense is going to do.
And Jennings going to take the handoff now.
Jim, no surprise there. You got the lead. It's late in the game. You run the football. Make that clock keep ticking. And you go over these situations so many times in practice. You got to manage the clock, know how much time you got left. They've done that well, and just keep running it.
The Cowboys stop the clock in a hurry, trying to hold on to every precious second. Should be an easy one here. The kick is good.
You got to take advantage of good field position. The offense doesn't do it that time. I know they get 3 points out of it. Nice kick, but still a letdown for the offense.
Signals and makes the fair catch. The Cowboys' offense still has a chance here, Phil. Late in the game, can they make something happen?
Well, it's going to be interesting to see, Jim. I think let's look at it from the defensive side. Know the situation. If they get the ball, they catch a pass, make sure you come up and make the tackle. Don't let them catch and run and get a big play against you.
Now
on first down. Every snap crucial the rest of the way. The Cowboys come out with a split backfield. First down at the 20. Airing it out. And it's incomplete. The one good thing about that incomplete pass, it stops the clock and they're able to preserve the one timeout.
Yeah, that's what you want to do. You want to get as many plays off as you can, Jim, by using getting your timeout, getting out of bounds, spiking the football. A lot of things to do here. We'll see if the offense is up for all of them.
Second down, late in the fourth quarter.
Get ready.
Second and 10. Dominique Rogers-Cromartie has an interception. Romo's has got